This episode is being recorded out of Shop Talk Podcast Studios in Oak Park, Michigan. For more information, visit www.shoptalkpod.com.
Just a D girl from around the way with a whole lot of shit to say. It's your girl, KD.
And
it's the hostess with the mostest, Kiki.
3 and a half.
Kiki, stop calling my damn name.
Chill. Man, y'all, I had to throw that one in there.
Bro.
What's up?
That was hilarious.
What's up?
We didn't know that was coming. Okay, go ahead.
That's what makes it so beautiful. All right. It's me, man. It's your boy, man. DTM, a.k.a.
Go ahead,
go for it, baby. Tell them what it is.
All I remember is you said, Mr. Energy, I have not one enemy.
It's your boy, DTM, a.k.a. B-I-G-T-A-Y, a.k.a. Pure Motivation, a.k.a. I am Mr. Energy. Everybody loves me. I don't think I have not one enemy. If you know me, then you know that I'm more than a savage who loves living life and is allergic to average. It's me, Deontay the Motivator. What's good, world?
I'm going to need you to work on your pronunciations.
Dang.
Why was he looking at you the whole time?
Avage.
Avage.
Because I'm his muse.
Hey, she going to put me in check quick.
Like he was doing a speech just looking at you like.
I do got one next week too, and I'm going to be like, she's going to be in the audience, and I'm going to be just looking at her like.
That's good though. They say imagine you see people naked, but if you see your boo in the audience, that's even better, right?
Yeah, and I already naked? Know she's naked, so you know what I'm saying.
I'm gonna have clothes on.
He probably always.
I just imagine.
Right.
You better tell her. You better tell her.
Cornball.
All right, man. So, man, we miss y'all. What's going on? What's going on? How was y'all week so far?
Fantabulous.
It's been good.
Good. Going into this holiday week, a little short week for us next week. You know what I'm saying? Good. We got graduation to prepare for and proms to prepare
excited.
For. And yeah, man. Yeah, my man is all up in our pockets, right?
Yes.
Man. Sure. I'm talking about all the. If he think he smell a dollar, he be like, oh, you know what else I need?
And then on the top of that, you want to add some side notes like, you know, I really want some corned beef. Like, dog, it's like 10 of y'all. How you going to get.
That's, he like,
that's $100.
Is y'all gonna be by 7 miles in Southfield? We was like,
no.
He like, well, it's a corned beef place over there that we really want.
We'll
clean our whole room. I'm talking about you could eat off their floor right now.
Oh my goodness.
My man went mopping the ceiling trying to get this corned beef so bad.
They was doing laundry. They was folding clothes. I said, dude, what they put in the corned beef?
And we got the corned beef, and that corned beef stank.
What?
I was like, what is it? I ain't going to say where it came from, because I just said it stank, and I don't want to throw them out there like that.
Oh, no.
But
they
it could have just been
though.
A bad batch. Right.
Yeah, they ate it.
They did kill it.
They was excited.
I'm like, whoa. All right. So those who don't know, we are recording a little bit earlier today. So we're going to skip about that life, and we're going to do something different.
Uh-oh.
It's one that we've done before, but I don't think Kiki was the part of the one we've done before, but I'm sure she heard it. So this one is describe that position.
I was looking at it and I had no idea what it was. I guess I'll find out.
Yeah.
What is happening?
I'm down for new challenges.
So describe that position is basically, I'm going to give you guys a name of the position, and you guys got to tell me what you think that position is, like how you think it goes.
Okay.
All right. So the first one is the bicycle.
I would imagine that with like the girl on top, maybe in a chair or something.
Okay.
I think that might be my favorite position if I'm thinking right. Because I think it's in a chair too.
In a chair.
Like riding in a chair.
Like riding a bike.
Yeah.
Okay. So how this position is, the girl is in a push-up position.
Whoa.
Oh.
Right. But her butt is in the air.
What?
Her legs are like kind of closed, and the guy is behind her with his legs as if he was on a bike.
Mm.
And he's hitting it from the
so
back
he's
in that
on
position.
The bike. We're thinking she was on the bike.
Okay. Yeah. So that's the bicycle.
Okay.
It looks very intriguing. Some of them I was looking at, I was like, nah, this one is impossible. But, you know, other ones was like, oh, okay. All right.
I imagine you got like a Kama Sutra app, because where you come up with this shit?
Right.
Bro.
All right. So This one is called the orchid.
It's called an orchid.
Orchid. Oh, my orchid? Or orchid?
H is silent?
It is.
Well, we ain't gonna, just, we giving them the H this time.
How you gonna give them what they didn't have?
Because it just had the spelling. It didn't really say how it was supposed to be pronounced.
Okay.
But that's what it's called. You're orchid, orchid, however you want to do it.
We ain't recording this early no more. You on the road today. Let's
talk. Describe that position.
It's a flower, so I'm not sure how that would go.
I don't even have a clue.
Now, I thought this position might be pretty interesting.
Something with the legs open, I imagine. Like the woman with the
legs. Yeah, by like being the flower. Open, blooming. Like blooming.
Right.
Okay, so y'all semi-right. The legs are open. But this position, the girl is actually in a headstand with the legs open.
Oh.
And the guy is eating her out.
Oh.
So imagine being ate out in a headstand.
We'll have to try that one.
I think we've done that before, haven't we?
I haven't done
like
that.
Like off the bed, though. Like.
Yeah. Yeah.
That sounds like it would be good if you can balance yourself on the bed.
Yeah.
Like the woman and then the man could just be laying across the bed and eating that way. Interesting.
Okay. All right.
I'm gonna add that to the
repertoire.
To the list of things I need to do.
On her bucket list.
Mm-hmm.
On her fucking right. bucket list.
Definitely. Because it definitely sounds interesting.
It does.
All right. Let me see. What's the next one? I'm going to give you one more. Just one more. Let's do the crucifixion. This sound real painful to me just off of the name. But
I know. Like, why would you want to name it that, though? Is it like...
Somebody laying on standing up.
Standing up with your arms out?
I'm like on a cross?
Yeah.
That's what
I'm thinking. Yeah. Think of a cross. So I'm
yeah.
I would think somebody would be.
Like, you know.
Right.
I don't know, up against the wall. All
right, so imagine this part right here. The man is sitting on his, he's sitting down. He on his feet, though. You know, like kind of on his knees, but still on his feet.
Mm-hmm. Like squatting?
Like kneeling down.
Okay.
Okay.
But on his feet. He moves backward, and then he rests his arms like behind him, but apart. So right. like he kind of leans back,
yeah. Okay.
And then the girl is sitting on top of him, kind of leaned back with him, but she is more like in a squatting position.
So she riding him.
So she's riding him while he's on his knees,
that
kneeled back.
Uncomfortable.
That's
it,
not
it
uncomfortable.
Sounds super
and
uncomfortable.
And the penis. Yeah. Is like,
that sounds super.
How do you
uncomfortable.
Align the private area? Yeah, I don't like that.
Yeah, I don't like that one either.
That one, I was looking at it, I was like,
I wouldn't
nah.
try that one.
No, you
it's
keep
too
that.
Uncomfortable.
Yeah, that sounds like you got to be like super drunk for one. You only going to get
about. If you're too drunk,
yeah.
you're going to fall.
Exactly.
You're already
not gonna
down.
You're going to be able to balance yourself
right.
that way.
You got to, I don't know.
Because you're going to have to balance because if she riding you,
right.
you're not going to just be able to be drunk, toppling over.
Right.
Like, everybody going to be on the floor.
I think the worst part about that one is if she's in shape and you're not, you got to play it off like you don't want
to
come. Wait.
Ooh, to
hold
keep
on.
Up.
Hold on.
Just jump up and run out the room like, oh, I saw a spider.
I got to use the bathroom.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
All right.
It's that, too early for y'all.
So, yeah. So that's it, man. That's that name, that position. I had a bunch more, but I was like, I don't know. He's right here.
I feel like he just sit and read Kama Sutra apps all day. That's
Nah, see, I'm always working, man. You know what I mean? I'm always looking for new stuff to bring you guys because, you know, we just want to help somebody out here, you know? Somebody going to put this in their repertoire.
Yeah.
In the repertoire.
Yeah. All right, so the next segment we got for you guys today, this is one of my favorite ones, you know, because this shows you how much KD be on her game. And this one is, are you smarter than KD? She was running the table for a minute. She had one.
Only person that ever beat me was Jay.
Yeah, she had one person that was on her head. So we're gonna try this one here. Are you
and
smarter
actually,
than
first
KD?
Of all, first of all, sidebar. He beat me by like one.
One. Yeah.
So don't act like he like beat me by 100.
No, I ain't saying that. But I am saying that everybody else who came at you, you murdered them. So, you know, I'm saying.
Shut up.
Shut up.
All right. So. First question four, are you smarter than KD is? What is the number one, what city is number one for the most promiscuous cities in the world?
Miami?
I was supposed to answer first.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
My bad.
My bad.
He was looking at me. Well, how can I be smarter if I don't answer first?
Oh, my bad. Go ahead.
I would have said Miami. Number two would have been Vegas.
I say either Miami or Atlanta.
You know what? And when I was looking these up, I was thinking Miami. I was kind of thinking, like, you know, the Florida area, California area, whatever. But that's all wrong. That's all wrong.
What?
What is it?
The city, the number one city.
Utah.
Denver.
Denver?
Denver.
Who the fuck even go to Denver?
Man.
I guess there nobody got to come there because everybody else already coming there.
Exactly.
They're like, oh, no, we got Denver?
That seems boring, though. What's in Denver?
But that's why. Because there's nothing to do there.
Yeah.
I mean, I get that, but.
Except fuck.
Okay.
Because they don't have nothing. They don't have no beaches. They don't have no amusement parks. So for entertainment, they have sex.
They had Carmelo for a minute.
I don't. He
was having sex.
All right. Do that. So
my bad. All right. Number two.
My bad.
What is a acorn? Now, y'all remember what the show is all about. So don't give me no that little thing that fall off the tree. No, what is an acorn? This is relationship reality.
Acorn.
Talk to him.
A penis?
Kiki.
I don't.
Kiki.
You said a penis?
I guess.
KD?
An anal plug?
That's a good guess. The answer, I guess I can give it to Kiki on that one.
Aww.
The answer is the head of a penis or a small penis.
Acorn. Small penis.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God. Okay.
All right. So, question number three. What does this term mean? ASL. ASL.
And like text talk or like?
This is in like lifestyle or talk.
I have no idea. Sex. Line. I don't know. I have no idea.
Katie, what you got?
This is a good one.
A significant lover?
That was a good guess.
Or a single lover?
A single lover. Final answer? That was a good guess.
I have no idea.
You are absolutely wrong.
Why you get the bell for wrong?
So it is.
You got good ones today.
I know. Yeah.
So it is. I give it two terms. I give it the first term is anus shaped lips. Or the other word for anus, sucking lip.
Ass sucking lips?
Mm-hmm. Mm. All right.
We're going to start making these multiple choice.
Yeah, I wouldn't know about that one.
You know what? The next one is going to be not multiple choice because I'm going to give y'all. So define this term, DNA.
How's that multiple choice?
Ain't no. Right.
You said the next one was multiple choice.
You did
choice.
Say the next one was going to be multiple choice.
I thought, I kind of meant like the next.
Oh, the time next time we play.
This. Yeah. Next time we do this, I got to put the multiple choice on here. I don't want to just start making up. Like, I want to start making DNA. Up stuff on the spot. I mean, I can do that now. Y'all want me to make up stuff on the spot?
DNA.
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 Not the ass. I have no idea.
She said, do not the ass. That's kind of what I was thinking, too.
What'd you say? Dude, what'd you say?
Huh?
What'd you say?
Do no anal. All
right, so you are in the right vicinity of it.
Dick nut anal?
Dick in
anal?
Oh, dick in anal.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking anal, though. For sure.
I knew it was anal. It was just what
I said.
What about the anal? We get half points for that.
Yeah, I give y'all a half a point for that one. All right, so I'm going to give you one more, and then we can get into some show content.
We
got to
make this multiple choice.
Multiple choice?
It's way
because you on some bullshit.
Okay.
You want us to guess some shit?
I got you.
You know that you already knew.
Okay. A cuckold, C-U-C-K-O-L-D, a cuckold is A, obsessed with older men, B, obsessed with older women, or C, turned on by watching or thinking about watching women sleep with another man.
A.
C.
You said A? So did you say A just because you just remembered the letter or you remember what it was?
No, I said A.
And you said C? And so the answer is A.
Yay!
Obsessed with older men.
I mean,
that's how she knew it.
Right. It's both.
That's like right up her alley, bro.
I mean, I'm saying, I'm a professional at that one.
Yikes.
What? Yeah.
Bro, I'm not about to play with
keep
you.
Keep them coming.
I just want to, for the record, I'm not finna play with you. For the record.
And...
Definitely professional at that one, but go ahead, next.
So that was it. That's it.
Oh, that's Kiki it. Won.
Yay.
Man.
That one was hard, though.
That was ridiculously hard, sir.
So the next one I'm going to do, it's gonna definitely have all multiple choice boys.
Gotta be
there.
Multiple choice.
You're like making us think when we've been drinking already. It's not a good look.
And it's super early, y'all.
It's super early.
So we're going to give him a pass on that one there. All right, bet. Man, y'all ready to get to the show content?
Yeah. Let's get it. Know?
Favorite. All right. Everything is my favorite. I say that about everything.
That's my favorite.
All right. So, quick question. I got a question for y'all. How aggressive is too aggressive in the dating world?
So, I think in the beginning it shouldn't be super aggressive because that turns me off. Like in the beginning, I've met people where they're just like, gotta call you all the time, gotta text you all the time, gotta do everything all the time. And it's just too much for me. Like it'll turn me off where I'm like, block. You know what I mean?
So you meaning that they doing it to you too much?
It's just too
much.
Doing it to... Like in the beginning, you shouldn't be calling every single day, all day, and texting me every single day, all day. To me, that's too aggressive. That's too much for me.
So that's the aggressive part, doing too much.
It's just too much. I think it just needs to flow naturally, not just be what you're doing all day in the beginning. Like, let's just take it day by day and date and get to know each other and go out and, you know, set dates, but not just all day, every day. Like, we are, like, exclusive from the beginning. Like, right. It's too much for me. So that turns me off, and I get to, I like to block quickly. So,
block?
I will block you if you're doing too much. Like, one time, it was a guy. He introduced himself, you know, nicely or whatever. I'm, you know, such and such, from whatever. But then he's like, do you have Facebook? And I'm like, yeah. So he's like, okay, I'm going to add you on Facebook. But I didn't add quickly enough, apparently, right? Because when I seen him again, he was like, did you add me? Because I see you didn't add me on Facebook.
That was a rhetorical
question.
And I'm
like,
you just answered it.
Like, you already knew that I didn't add you, right? So then he started, like, instant messaging me. Like,
calling you on Facebook?
Yes. No, he didn't call me, but he was
in her DM.
It was in my DM. So he was like asking questions like, are you going to add me on Facebook? And I'm like, goodness.
So I actually know.
So then he's like, I can see you read it, but you didn't reply. And I'm like, are you? That's just too much for me, right? Like, I'm not even on there like that for people to even like DM me. So I'm like, I've seen it, but I didn't reply. But he's like, yeah, you didn't reply, and I seen you seen it.
He like, it say red. I was like, you left me on red.
Left me on
yeah,
red.
Yeah, it was blocked after that because I'm like, it's too
but see,
much.
That,
it's
that
too
at the beginning is showing you that he got like a possessive.
It's red flags
yeah,
for me, right?
That's definitely red flags. Yeah, that's so, like, that's showing like a possessive personality.
Yeah, I don't like that.
Like, if we were to ever hook up, you would just be like, where you at? What mm-hmm. you doing? Like, mm-hmm. you trying to get my location? Like, bruh.
This was in the same week.
The see, no.
So, you know what I mean? So you can imagine how like anything would have went.
That's
further.
Scary.
Oh, yeah. After he,
right?
Especially after he gets some, it's gonna be yeah. it's gonna
too
go
much.
Time.
She like,
50.
No thanks.
Like, thanks, but no thanks.
No
so
thanks.
Can yeah. you do certain things that can be considered aggressive, like sending too early dick pics or
pussy pics. Definitely. Or shower yeah. pics.
You know, we don't like that anyway.
Shower pics.
Yeah, you know, like something. Like, I'm about to hop in the shower. I got the bubbles or not shower, but bathtub, bubble water, whatever.
Why would I want to see that?
Well, that wouldn't like, be you talking about like for women. Men?
But yeah. We send it. Oh, okay.
I'm about to say that. I wish a nigga like, would send me that. A picture in the tub. Yeah.
So, like, do you
a
think...
bubble bath with a glass of wine. Talking about thinking of you. Bitch, you meant to send that to Kevin, not Keisha. No, that's going to be a no for me, boss.
But, yeah, so if a woman does that, is that too early? Is there a time but when I that could be considered
I think
too early?
Men are more receptive exactly. in the beginning than women are.
Yeah.
If you meet a chick.
They want to see
that.
It.
Is that, yeah. Men want to so see if you it. Meet a chick and yeah. then that same week she's sending you like a nude or like a bath pic or whatever, y'all into
happy.
That.
Right.
That ain't, I'm good. You keep your dick to yourself, please.
So what? So if the woman asks the man for the dick pic like in the first week or two,
I'm sure
is that considered aggressive though?
I mean, she's telling you what she wants, but men don't care exactly.
So y'all go.
Men like if somebody hits you up in the beginning like, hey, let me see a pic or whatever, y'all like, hell yeah, because she already telling you. That's her way of telling you she trying
want
to fuck.
It, right.
She trying to see the package right. before she invites you over. Because if it ain't.
But I'm not sending anything in a week. No. Okay? You're not going to see none of this body.
No. Not no week.
In
no.
1 week? No.
7 not, days? No.
Not even like the early morning smile? Hey, just woke up thinking of you. No. Click, click.
No, in a week?
You'll see, when we go on a date, you'll see me. Yeah. Like, I'm not sending you pictures and stuff that early. That's just me, though.
First of all, in the first week, you probably not the reason why I'm smiling anyway.
Right.
It depends, though. I mean, what if my man was just like, everything you've been looking for in that first week so far.
You don't know. You don't know.
Yet, though. You got to get to know somebody first.
In a week, he pretending to be everything
exactly.
you want.
Right. So what if he a good pretender in that week? Mm-hmm. You like, bet. I like how he pretending.
That might work for these young whippersnappers.
We are older now.
Because I was about to say, we know that this generation ain't even really trying to go out.
Yeah.
Ain't
oh,
no, it's ain't no dating.
First of all, they date on Instagram.
Yeah.
That's
I've been
date.
Knowing you for 6 years already.
First of all, watching you.
The date is, I'm about to give you my Netflix password. We both going to log in and watch the same movie.
You tell me what you think. Actually,
on FaceTime, though.
I cannot.
Got,
it is a lot of FaceTime.
I got teenage boys. That's all they do all day. They FaceTime. They go to the room. They ain't taking these girls to no dinner. Nothing.
Straight to it.
And that ain't even how they was brought up, and that's not how I'm bringing them up. They like, my, we got time for that
that's
later
this
on.
That's generation now.
But it's because that's what the girls want. That's what not even so now. Much what they want. Yeah. Like, my oldest son had a little chick he was trying to, like, date, take her to the movies, take her out to eat, whatever. She like, oh, my God, all you want to do is hang out. Like, he like, well, what you want to do? Like, oh, just want to fuck.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, well.
Yeah, that's crazy. And
it's
think
now.
It gets super weird. When one party is trying to date and the other party is not trying to date. Mm-hmm. So it's like, wait a minute. Wait, okay. But then what happens when the role reversal and you like, okay, bet. Well, let's just do this. And now you just want to date. And now you just confused. Like, wait a minute. You confused me. What's going on here?
Yeah.
All right. So do you think that people who are 100% happy and satisfied in their relationship cheat?
I guess it depends.
I think they can because I think that cheating is not about satisfaction.
I don't think it's about sex either.
Sometimes, like, I think for women, sometimes it's like if they're cheating, it's because they're missing something. Mm-hmm. Rather be sexually, emotionally, physically, whatever. But for men, they just do shit. Like, it's no rhyme or reason
it's just
behind
physical
it.
For
yeah,
for the man. Yeah,
yeah. Like they see somebody they want to hit and they hit. Mm-hmm. Like it's nothing to do with like
emotions or nothing.
Yeah,
like that.
their happiness or their sadness or nothing. It's just like meh.
So
it's
so,
Tuesday.
Mm-hmm. So Kiki, what's your definition of cheating?
For me, cheating would be because I'm an emotional person. So like if you texting somebody like you know I miss you, I love you, and all of that, that's cheating to me. Like, of course, physical is cheating, but I think emotional is way worse than the physical.
Sure.
So, yeah, if you're invested in somebody, texting them all the time or anything like that, that's cheating for me.
That's for sure.
Katie, what you say?
That's for sure. Like, because you're building up an emotional connection with somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
So, to me, like, the physical is like, okay, you slept with this person and you never think about them again.
You can get over the physical.
Yeah, you can.
But when it's an emotional
that
relationship.
That emotional affair is way more painful because it's like, men have a way of sleeping with people and never even thinking of them again. Like somebody even walked up to you like, oh, you remember we hooked up like in 2012? You'll be looking like, I never seen you look familiar to me.
I never seen you before.
Like she'll have a whole scenario and you'll be dead ass like, I don't understand. But somebody who you've been texting, calling, spending time with, going out to lunch, all these things, that's somebody who has captured your attention and
a part
of your heart.
Right.
That's really your girlfriend.
Right.
Because you're investing into that person. Right. That to me means like, okay, so you were straight up looking for something else. You wasn't just looking for sex. You was looking for a companion. I'm going to need you to pack your shit and leave. Appreciate you.
Good answer. So, good answer. So my definition of cheating would probably be simple, and it's basically anything that you do secretly that you don't want your significant other to see, or you're trying to hide it or whatever.
Yeah.
So I agree with y'all on what both of y'all said, but if you do that openly, then I don't think that it's cheating, because it's like, look, I'm showing you.
Well, anything in the light is not cheating.
Right.
Because that's apparently it's a mutual understanding on the table.
Exactly.
Right. But anything you have to delete, it's wrong.
Yeah. Right.
I guess that's the way to look at it. If you doing something, you're like, oh, shit, let me hurry up and delete this before somebody else sees it.
Right.
Then that's how you know. That's I feel like that's like your main, if you don't know it's cheating, if you're like, oh, shit, I got to delete this because if my girl or my guy see it, it's going to be a problem. Mm-hmm. Then you cheating. Right. If you got to have a code on top of a code next to a code around the corner from a code,
right?
Because you don't know if that person gonna text you, which is something that DTM you say all the time. I can't control what people text me. Yeah, because the rest of the conversation is missing, and nobody know what you said to her.
Right.
Right.
So when you got to have all those codes in case that person texts you something off the chain, and your significant other has your phone, that's cheating.
Right.
Yeah.
If you afraid, like, if your significant other got your phone and you over there sweating bullets, like, please don't let this bitch text me because I don't know what she gonna say.
Right.
Then you've already started the affair.
That's it.
That's true.
That's it. All right, so let's talk fantasy for a minute, y'all. Let's start with Kiki.
Mm-hmm.
Walk us through one of your fantasy scenarios.
Well, my fantasy is still to have a threesome one day, like when I'm married. So I would like to meet somebody and, like, I don't know if it's like a fantasy, but I would like to just bring somebody in and just have just a good time, because we almost had one time and it was, I don't know what happened.
I don't know what happened
that night, but it was hot and heavy, and we met somebody, and then I don't know, you know, I was drunk, so I don't remember what.
Damn,
happened.
Did you have one and don't remember?
I don't think we did.
Oh shit!
I'm not sure. That would be right.
But that's the fantasy that I still want to fulfill one day, like just having a good night with somebody else, bringing just an extra.
Yeah.
Extra one day. So that's still on my bucket list.
A little hot sauce on the chicken.
Yeah.
Katie?
Yeah. I think one of my fantasies, you know, it's hard because we probably have done mostly
everything almost.
Like,
almost.
Like,
just 20 years.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I used to always be like, oh, I can't wait to like have sex on the beach. You know what I'm saying? Done it. Like, you know what I mean?
Oh, that's
like,
still a fantasy.
Like, I can't have, I want to have sex on the balcony. Like, oh, done it. Like,
done that, yeah.
Like, I don't think there's much, even like having sex in front of people, we
done it.
Did that. So it's like,
right. It's not much more.
It's not much.
Do.
I mean, like, I guess the only thing left is like a successful threesome. Yeah. But that's.
I guess the beach would kind of be a fantasy.
The beach was so bomb.
I've never
bomb,
done
though.
It on the beach.
The beach
before.
Was so bomb.
Cause that's like
I
nice.
Would recommend,
especially
the
in
beach.
Front of people.
Yeah,
like they don't know what's going on. And you,
yeah.
Oh my god,
I would recommend the
I would
beach
do it
to do
late.
A blanket.
I would do it. At night.
Yeah,
we did it in the daytime and at night. When was in Miami?
Y'all so hot.
But I would definitely do a blanket because remember the first time we did the towel.
Yeah.
And
okay,
the towel
so a
actually
blanket
and the towel actually sinks into the sand.
Right.
And. Getting sand out of your vagina,
vagina.
And your ass
yeah.
is so.
I can imagine.
And it's like you wash and you wash and
it's
you wash, but it's sand,
right.
So it's like
it's in there.
You rubbing it,
it's in there.
So it's like, yeah. Especially like on your vagina, it's like
oh,
so painful. And then like you get out the shower and then you go and then you like I didn't get it all.
That's the word.
You know what I'm saying? So now you go, even if you submerge, because I submerged, remember I went in a hot tub.
Right.
It just took a while to get all the sand.
So you need
off. And I waxed. So it's not like it was like stuck in here. Right. It was just
in there.
It was like souped into the vagina. Like was really the moisture. It was it was amazing.
Yeah.
But then at night we used a blanket and it was cool. Okay. Like I didn't have no sand. Hmm. Nowhere. I was
at
good.
Night is less people too. So it's like,
and it's like a cool breeze.
But I like the thrill of people like maybe seeing you sometimes. So yeah. It's like hot.
It was
so during the daytime would be hot.
It was mild.
The problem now is before, back, you know, when we did it, people will watch or they'll see, or you probably wouldn't know it.
Right.
But now they want you to know that they see you. Mm-hmm. They're going to look at you and you're a world star or something.
And video and right,
they can't, you ain't going to get paid for it.
That's
so
true.
You know, I make everybody sign a waiver if they're going to come stand and watch.
I can't.
Y'all come sign this waiver before y'all come recording this over here.
I remember one time we did it at Belle, and it was like recently when the like state troopers are there. It was so hot.
Like, let's see,
and
we
it was
get
like somebody
up.
Watching from the other side of the river. Like, they were just watching.
Oh my God. Let's see if we go to jail.
It was, it was almost a few times, but yeah.
Not a few times.
Yeah.
That's how you keep it spicy.
It is. I mean, it definitely makes it hot. I don't want to go to jail. I don't mind a few people watching.
But you know what, man? I don't think they'll take you to jail unless y'all wasn't supposed to be doing it. Like, if y'all wasn't, if you was like a hooker or something.
Yeah, we done been to some places where, like, the police pulled up. Why are y'all here?
Like, what are y'all doing?
Yes. Like, let me see your license. Like, I thought I was going to go to jail for
real. Like, we're just talking. He's talking.
He's like, why didn't y'all get a room? I'm like, a room? Who does that? Like,
she's like, that ain't fun. We got a whole house, but that don't matter.
Exactly.
No, that's not. We're trying to have fun.
Yeah, we almost was in here.
We're not trying to be responsible.
And it's crazy because
it was early, like in daylight. We knew we weren't supposed to be there, and it was just like, let's do it, whatever.
But she's like, let's just see.
It's crazy because I talk about people who like shoot dice on the corner or smoke weed outside. Now you can, but who shoot dice on the corner, but they got a house or a basement or something. But then, yeah, still we doing the same thing, just sexually. Like,
that's true.
So, all right, well, I forgive y'all.
Dice is their sex. All right. Fuck it.
So, let me see. My fantasy scenario would probably be to be out of town or something somewhere.
It's always better out of town for
It's
somebody,
always
right?
better out of town.
It
because
is.
You can
let
be,
your hair down.
You don't have to be yourself. Like, you can be whoever you want to be when you be out of town.
You don't got to worry about running into nobody or like.
Yeah, I'm going to do it anywhere out of town.
Mine. Me with Jamaica one time when we went out of town.
We was in Vegas.
We was in Vegas and I turned into Jamaica.
You remember that?
What?
When we was in Vegas and we was standing by the bathroom and he had the conversation with the guy acting like he was from Jamaica.
Yes.
He said, where you from, man? I said, Kingston, bro. He said, you from Kingston? I said, yeah, man. He said, whoa. He said, what school you go to? I said, me left before school started, man. You know? They're going to do it like me do, you know? Possibly, yeah?
I cannot. So,
you could be whoever you want to be. Yeah, you could be who you want to be when you're in Vegas. You don't have to worry about, you know, none of that. So my man would be probably out of town somewhere. Mm-hmm. And almost similar to how I brought that white girl back and said, oh, babe, can we keep her? But this time it would be like me walking in with like maybe some ice or the liquor or the cups or something that we need from wherever. And y'all would just be in the bed. And I wouldn't know that it was a y'all. I would have thought it was just a you. And I'm like, yeah, I'm about to get to it. And then when I came in the room, it's like two of y'all. I was like, oh, shit.
And they're like, come join
like,
us.
Come
like,
on.
Come
yeah.
on.
Yeah. Like the old school porn that had like the themes to it.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm.
Like a plot.
Yeah. So, yeah, I think that would probably be my scenario right there.
Okay.
We're going to order a hoe.
Oh.
Go out of town. www.needahoe.com.
You don't even have to order. You could just look. Like, you go out to the club.
Oh, yeah, it's so many people that want it. Yeah, people want it. That's why I don't understand how people really making money off sex these days, honestly. Because everybody want it now.
First of all, people making money off Instagram videos. Like, they make these private pages, and if you cash app them money, then they accept your friend request, and then
what?
You could go on the page and watch them, like, masturbate or like nude shot. Hey,
look,
yeah.
Look, somebody told me that, right?
Never heard.
And I'm like, well, what's the difference? Like, what are you offering that Pornhub don't have?
Hey, that's what I'm saying. And, just go on
and,
other
and they just stopped talking to me because I guess they couldn't answer.
But you
got
to think about it, like, so that type of stuff wouldn't appeal to somebody older, but I'm sure she got some young people on there.
Hey, I'm like, I can go to Pornhub and get it for free. I can turn over to my right and I can see it for free. I'm confused.
Yeah, but they making money though. Like,
it ain't like I know you personally and I've been trying to see you.
What
for the
are
longest.
They doing,
like,
different?
Yeah,
that's what it is.
Yeah, right? That's true.
But like, making money.
I'm not gonna pay to watch you
masturbate. Right, like, she couldn't answer that. So I was like, yep, nope, not happening.
She's like, no, he's not for me. He's not
gonna.
She's
pay. Like, oh, you got
ask too many questions.
Not pay. Like, what do you mean questions?
Yeah, too many questions.
You're just supposed to cash at me the money. You're not supposed to ask questions.
I'm trying to think of something like that, man. Look, man, that's y'all
crazy.
Cash at me, man. If y'all want
cash
this podcast
for
early,
now. Oh my goodness,
yeah.
Y'all want this podcast a day earlier, man. Cash at me, I got you. Let's see if this works.
I cannot.
Let's see if this works.
Bro, you so petty.
All right, so next question: how often do you have a conversation in your relationship about sex?
Often.
And not just the conversation like, oh, babe, that was dope last night. You killed it. Like the conversation where you like, oh, when you did so-and-so, I didn't really like that.
Yes.
But if you twist it like this, that might be better.
I like to say what I liked and what I didn't like because, it makes it better, right? Like you have to communicate with your spouse or partner to let them know what you like and what you don't like because I don't want you to do this ever again I didn't like it.
If I don't tell you and you do it again,
how would you know?
I can't get upset.
Right.
Right. And,
but I want you to know that I don't like it because I don't want you to do that shit again.
Exactly.
Like, you remember that?
Yeah.
Forget
don't
that.
Do it.
Mm-mm.
And some, you know, I think
I never
for
had
men,
one though that was well with my current relationship that I didn't like though. Like when he'd like flip and roll me and pick me up, like I mean it's all good. So I don't think, you know, besides the one
but,
little incident.
I mean, but even in that, you would be it's some of that you probably like way more than all
exactly.
The
and so, I say that like I did like when you did such and such, and then you know
throw
I don't want
there.
It every time though. I had to make that clear because it's like. He was, like, thinking, I want it every time if I say something. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like,
because you said you liked it.
Like, I did like it in the ass, but I don't want it every time.
Right.
So you have to be clear.
Yeah.
You have to be a little specific sometimes.
That's
because
true.
Yeah.
I don't want it every time, but I did like it occasionally, right?
Yeah. For sure.
That
conversation
mean,
has to be had.
And us as men, if you just say, man, I really like that, then we probably feel like, okay. She really like that. That's gonna
so
be
I'm going to do it every time. So she'd be sad.
And mentally for me,
time.
I don't say I'm going to do it every time. I say, okay, bet. That's going to be my go-to.
Right.
Like,
right. That's on a good
I'm putting
night.
That on,
yeah.
You know
like,
that?
Oh, we had a good night. I'm
like,
definitely going to go to that.
Oh, yeah.
That's my go-to boy right there.
For
so,
sure.
Yeah. Nah.
And you got to know your spouse's like body movements or like, we got a way of letting y'all know what we
want.
But you have to be in tune with what we telling you without actually...
Yeah, because I think
in a moment we're not gonna be like, oh, do this.
Oh, I do though sometimes. I'd be like, oh, I want it in there.
Well, I do that too.
Right, but sometimes he said that's too aggressive. If I say like what I want when I want it,
so you gotta
like,
do
he's
a
like,
move.
I just want to be the man and like be aggressive and do what I want to do.
He like, I
want
to control.
So every
sometimes.
Once in a while, you can say what you want, but other than that, like let me do me.
But
which
and,
I respect.
But
right?
And that's what
let me be the cook in the kitchen.
Right.
And that's why the conversations are so
right.
important because
exactly.
I feel like some people don't have these conversations,
mm-hmm.
and then they just either end up cheating or just don't
exactly.
like what they're in.
Yeah.
They like,
right.
I don't like this nigga. I already know. Come on. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But yeah,
remember
no,
that, who
you
was
gotta,
that? Kevin Hart it was like, I know. After 2 minutes, roll over. I know.
All right. Yeah.
I know. After 3 minutes,
like it's all
oh,
scripted.
Yeah.
That's so boring.
You got the script.
Oh
it,
yeah,
like,
you
so
got it.
That's so boring.
Like,
but I don't like that. Sometimes he want me to stay on top for 40 minutes. I'd be like, look, dog, I'm tired. Okay. Don't keep me up there for that long. Like swap, swip, flop.
Bro, she said don't keep me up there. Like right. I didn't come.
I'm tired. You remember I worked 10.5 hours a day, okay? So on a weekday, nigga, don't keep me up there for 40 minutes and I'm tired.
I got a good
flip,
bro. We gotta switch something.
So what's y'all go to position?
Mine be from the back.
From the back.
Yeah.
That's like the finisher though. We can't do that too.
That's
soon.
What you mean, right?
Yeah. Like when y'all like, okay,
like
all
right, I'm done. All right, let me get this nut right quick.
You just gonna keep going.
Oh,
you ain't gonna never.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay.
Though. Yeah.
I know how to get it. Hold on 1 second. Flip
yeah,
it.
That's true.
toot that ass. It's,
that's true. It's a rap battle.
Too many tops.
I wonder what it is about that position right there. That just...
I think because from the back, the penetration is deeper.
And I think they like to see their ass
clapping.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They like to see their ass flopping on that thing.
Yep. Especially so when you, like, then you bounce it back real good.
Yeah. Oh, it's a wrap. It's a wrap after
it's
that.
Don't let me be like ready, then do the stand up with the bounce back.
Too much.
A minute.
Can't handle it.
60 seconds. It's,
yeah.
Ain't no hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on.
They be like, no. We can't start with that. Hold on. No. I love them. No. Not that.
Hold on, babe. No. Wait.
Oh, not that shit.
Are y'all playing? Oh, you think this funny? That's because you about to start an argument. Like, oh, wait a minute. Oh, you want to start like this? Huh? So what you saying? You want a quickie? That's what you saying?
What
you ain't
is.
Trying to
for real.
You ain't trying to get in. You just want to quit. Okay.
And we never do that. I be hoping for that sometimes because I be tired. But it's like you get energy when you get
the fucking get all
like
energized.
I was tired,
and shit, like,
but you know what?
Mom, whoa, you want a sandwich, babe? You want a sandwich?
Yeah. All right. So in this world today, we know that this part right here of sex is probably gone. But let me get y'all a definition of what you think foreplay is.
It's not. Who said it's gone?
In the younger generation,
I'm gonna say.
In our generation.
Oh, okay.
Foreplay starts even before we see each other.
I'm like, definitely.
You know what I'm saying?
The pictures.
Yeah, the pictures, the conversations. We getting it led up to it, but.
Yeah.
The younger generation is like, no, nah, what are we talking about it for? Let's just go ahead.
Mm-hmm. I know. I heard the boy say that they're like, I don't kiss nobody
in
the mouth.
Kissing and all that.
Like, you having sex and you don't kiss? That's, like, ugh, that's nasty. Like, what?
But you know what? That's only with somebody that you love and that you, like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, feel that bond with.
Yeah.
You don't just have foreplay with anybody, right? So,
yeah. It got to be like the kissing, the touching. Yeah.
The sensual side you want to do with the person that you are in love with.
The massage.
Yeah. Oh, I love those.
Y'all didn't see the air quote.
Oh, I did do the air quotes.
The air quote, the massage.
Babe, let me rub your back. Like,
that gets you in the mood.
Like, first of all.
With the oil?
Oh, my God.
Hey.
Let me rub your back with that lotion that you love so much.
Oh, man,
she got this lotion, yo.
I need to find some.
You know
well, I don't know what it is about this lotion. When I tell you, he goes crazy. It's like a Bath and Body Works. I think it's called Sleep.
Let me tell you something.
I'll put you to sleep for real.
Not him. It wake his ass up.
and
get him in the mood.
So she know about this lotion. She know what the lotion do to your boy, right?
So she
know what
like,
it do.
She bring it out.
So when she put this lotion on, I already know what it is. Because I'm like, oh, you think, oh, okay.
I'm like, I'm just going to go to sleep. He be like, yeah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, wake your ass up.
No, you ain't even finna pretend like
no. Because the other day, for real, I did it on accident. Because all my lotion is on my what's it called?
Nice
dresser. So I was on my cycle anyway. So I'm like, okay.
What does that matter?
Nothing,
right?
Because I grabbed it and I put it on and I laid down. He was like,
"You finished?
Are you thinking about the lay down?" He like, "Why you put that lotion on?" I'm like, "Oh shit." I mean, we worked it out.
Right. I'm going to say, what does that mean?
All right. I'm saying.
We had this conversation the other day. That really means.
It don't mean nothing.
It's like, we got showers. We got towels. All kind of stuff that you
can. Ain't no red lights in this relationship.
It's definitely no red lights.
It's all yellow and green.
And you didn't go to the dentist. Okay. So
here you go.
I'm just saying. Like,
hey, there it is, man. I'm sitting here like.
Your throat works perfect.
It does.
He
likes
exactly. Oh, yeah. All right.
No red lights.
None.
So, the rough sham. Are y'all into the rough sham?
I'm not.
I don't. Sometimes.
I'm not.
You're not?
So, I like it soft and sensual. Like, I like to use the lotions on it. And like, I don't like
But
it.
I think.
I don't want you, like, ramming your shit down my.
So no face smashing, but if he is super into it, is that a deal breaker for you?
I mean, I like it when he like grabs my head and gets into it though, right? Like, but I don't want it so much where like I do that on purpose sometimes anyway because they like to hear that, right?
Yeah,
they want to hear like you struggling a little bit, right? So I struggle, I don't want it to be like
you want to look down and you want to see her sucking on it,
right?
And you want to. See her almost kind of struggling to get all of it in there.
Right.
And then you want to see yourself helping her get the rest of it in there. and then you want to see her almost about to like throw up or let it go, and you just like, yeah, this is it.
I don't like it like it,
but I don't
all
like
the time.
It super rough.
Yeah,
though.
But
I know
like
that's
all
what you do into that, so
it's like you
I
get
oblige.
turned on more when we like struggling. Like,
yeah,
it's like
because they feel like they got the big cock.
Yeah, that's a masculine feeling. But see, for me now, especially back when I used to drink. I used to do this one move, and I think she used to hate it, but I never took the time to ask her because I didn't want her to say yes.
I didn't want
her to say she hated it, but I would take, like, she would be shaming me, right? And I would take my leg and put it over her head, and then I would take my other leg, like in a figure four move, push down on it to the point where I'm going to hold it until she almost can't breathe, and then I'm going to let it go because I don't want it to down the dick, right?
That's too much.
But it's
like, I like to get choked, but not in that way.
No, I
didn't hate it.
Yeah,
that's why I've never brought it up again.
Yeah,
like, we're not ever doing it again.
But that was in my, like I said, that was in my drinking days. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I was like, you know, I'm not gonna ask her because I don't want her to say she don't like it.
That's too much for me.
Yeah,
right? it was too much. I don't want to not be able to breathe that way though.
But
when I'm on top,
I knew she couldn't take it
and choke.
Like I knew she ain't like it because. Once she felt that leg, that one leg going over, and I would ease it over. I wouldn't do it fast. I would ease that leg over. And once she felt that one leg coming over, like I could look down. I could see in her eyes, like, this nigga here finna get me. he finna get me. So she trying to tap out, but I'm like, ain't no referee, so no,
oh
I can't stop yet. I'm going to stop as soon as that eye start to go down a little bit, and I'm going to let it go. Now you can breathe. All right, go back at it.
Oh, my goodness.
But that was, you know, then with the rough day.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
It's too much, though, I think.
It is.
For me.
It was definitely too much.
I need to be able to breathe.
It was on some bullshit.
that's when you know, being creative goes wrong, I guess.
I'm like,
okay,
creative.
Because, you know, for those who don't know, I do like watching wrestling from time to time. You know what I'm saying? Whenever she let me watch it, because she don't be letting me watch TV, y'all. I don't know why.
Oh, my God, I don't tell that lie.
You kind of got to be home.
No, she gotta not be home. For me to watch it.
No, only wrestling. First of all, it's 4 hours of bullshit.
It's so long.
It's a.
It can't be an hour like everything else. 4 fucking hours?
At least
no,
two.
No, I'm not watching that.
Two is the max. That's all I can make.
All right.
Two hours of football, 2 hours of basketball, two hours of anything. I can't make it over
four hours. That's half a damn shift. How much you paying me?
Too much.
you got paid with that move when I learned it. Like, oh,
no.
You know what?
That was.
What we doing at halftime? Because that. When is halftime?
We need
halftime. So halftime, I'm going to hook you up. We're going to hook each other up.
And then we
got
to go back because I'm going to sleep after because I don't. Yeah. I'm going to sleep after.
99.
You can go to sleep and then I'm going to wake you up again.
Right, because I don't want to watch no more of that though. So we can watch until halftime and then that's it.
Done.
If it was up to KD, we'd just be watching true crime all day, every day.
I mean, that's the bomb
probably
though.
True.
I woke up to that this morning.
Day.
Like.
Who the bleep did I marry?
I was watching
dope as fuck.
ID
all day. See?
Yeah, all morning when I woke up.
I'll just be like, wow.
I just go over Kiki's house. You stay there and watch wrestling.
All morning.
I go over Kiki's house.
All morning.
In the den, watch some ID.
I woke up at 4 and turned it on. Like, okay, ID channel. Good.
Yep. Check.
Check.
Check. Right.
You can never lose with that channel.
Ever.
So y'all take ID over Lifetime?
Definitely.
Yeah. Lifetime is not true crime. Lifetime
is
just
Lifetime,
movies.
But I like. Yeah.
Because I showed it, I pulled this one movie out. I was like, babe, look, I think you might like this. Because I try to find stuff that we can like together.
Together, right.
You know, because she's kind of like OD on the true crime boy. And I'd be like, all right, I got about, I'm like her with the wrestling. Like, I got about 2 hours, maybe. I can go three.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? 3 episodes here and there. But she like, nope, we got 5 more to go. And then we're going to go back because I might have closed my eyes on some. We're going to rewind. Like, babe, did we watch this one already? I missed a couple parts. How you know?
Like,
you already solved it before we even started. Like,
shut up.
But
me and my boo love it together, so we watch it together.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah,
that's
we love it together.
Yeah. And that's what I do. Because I love it too.
No, you don't.
Air quote.
The quotes.
Air quote.
Air quote. I love it too. So when it comes to sex, y'all, do you think that there's some parts of sex that can't be taught? Like either you got it or you don't? Or you think every part of sex can be taught? And you can get good at everything, at all that?
I think if you got the motion, then you got it.
I think every part can be taught because it's how you did it for somebody else is not how you may not be how you do it for me.
I don't agree.
But I think you got to have the basics, though. Like you got to have the basics.
You got to know how to work it, I think. Because that's never going to be taught.
You gotta, you gotta I think you got to have the basics. Rhythm. But the fundamentals can be taught. But the basics you got to have. And I don't necessarily think taught. I think it is more tailored. So you already know how to do it, but I like it like this. So you got to add learn a little bit of
your spouse.
Yeah.
Is what it is. You have to learn the person that you're intimate with.
Yeah.
Because it's different with everybody, right? So, yeah. I mean, you got to learn the person that you're with. You got to learn how they like it.
Yeah.
Right? So.
That's why I think it could be tailored. Not maybe not taught, but tailored for sure. Right.
Okay.
But you got to, I mean, you got to.
You got to come with something.
You got to have something, though.
You can't be like Limp Dick McGraw. Like, I can't fix that.
Right.
Sorry, bro.
All right. So, pet peeves. What's y'all pet peeves in the relationship? Just give me one.
In a relationship?
Yeah. Don't go down the whole list. Just give
my
me
biggest thing is communication. Like, that's just, I mean, yeah, it's if you don't communicate, you can't get anywhere. That's my number one pet peeve. Because you could do anything all day, and then if you don't communicate, like, it's like, I'm done.
Katie?
I would definitely say, like, lack of communication is my pet peeve, and also dishonesty. Like, I feel like I'm too open and I'm too accepting of stuff for a lie to have to be told.
Mm-hmm.
Like, to me, especially like with the mind frame that I have now, like, to me, if you lie in this time, it's just because you're an asshole.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like, I probably need to leave or some shit because you don't have a reason. You simply lying because you like, I'm a liar.
Just because, right.
And because I just want you to find out the truth and hurt your feelings. Like, I don't like care. That. Yeah. I ain't cool with that
either.
So y'all want to know what the top five pet peeves are?
Sure.
All right. So the number five pet peeve is the silent treatment.
Oh, my God. Ooh. I should have said that one.
The silent treatment is number five. Number four is being too friendly with your exes.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I can see that.
Number three is being unresponsive.
Will be like communication.
That's the same.
The number two is constantly comparing your relationship to others.
Mm, oh, yeah. That's the worst. I can see that.
And the number one pet peeve is being unreliable.
Oh, yeah. That's a good one.
So.
Yeah,
I can get it.
I tell people all the time, don't compare their relationship to other people.
You cannot, though, because everybody's so different.
And not only that, but you don't know what go on at home. Right. You talking about, he did this, this, and this, and I want you to do this, this, and this. Like, but you don't know what he doing at home.
Mm-hmm. Like, must be nice. Like,
she might be getting her ass whooped every day because
they
flowers.
Not communicating, though.
Yep,
at least
see?
Back to communication. I don't know what you're doing over there if you're not saying it.
Boom.
Boom, boom.
And let's see, we're going to do, are we doing Ask Katie?
No.
All right. Well, he had a good ass KD. She ain't really care for it that much. So we're not.
I don't think that's a good ass KD though.
Kiki, did you read it?
I did read it.
What, did you?
Do you think that's a good one?
I mean, it was kind of
interesting.
I mean, it was. Yeah, no, it wasn't really interesting.
So basically, the ass KD was.
It was okay.
A guy was dating somebody younger than him. Her vagina was not smelling great. He told her. She told a house up. They called the police and he went to jail. The question was, do I think that he should have told her?
I mean, how or did not tell? Though?
Or do I think that it was a different way that he could have told her?
That's
well,
just common sense, though.
Right. For one, I mean, she smelled her before he smelled her. Let's put that out there, for one. For two, I don't know how he said it, so how do I know if he should have said it differently? For three, he probably need to fuck around with somebody to take better care of herself.
Right. He did right not to sleep with her.
He definitely did right not to sleep with her.
I'm not sleeping with nobody
smells. Something probably ain't right. You got some vaginosis or something going on. So I don't think that he was wrong. I think she was wrong for the way she received it.
Right.
But at the same time, I wasn't there. So to ask, do I think he should have worded it differently?
No.
I don't fucking know how he worded
right,
it.
Right, no.
Do I think he should have told her?
No, because he should have told her. I'm not sleeping with nobody who smells like that.
I'm
so,
not.
Of course.
So he was not wrong. He should have told her.
He was not wrong.
He should not have slept with her.
Exactly.
And her dumb ass should have left with her funky pussy ass.
Right. I mean, it happened the way it was supposed to happen.
Exactly.
For me.
Like, no, he shouldn't have
gone to
jail.
I mean, I didn't want you to go to jail, but, I mean, at the end of the day, you should have told her she wasn't smelling right and you shouldn't have slept with her.
Exactly. And he need to date somebody who take better care of themselves. Because if you don't smell right, you smell you. I'm sure she went to the bathroom sometime throughout the night. They're hanging out, drinking, eating, whatever. Right. She knew she didn't smell right. But what she probably used to is messing around with young dudes who, even don't if care. You don't smell right, will hit that
care.
Anyway.
Who don't care. Yeah. Right.
So the fact that he was like, hold on.
They
don't care. You're a little tart
down exactly. here.
So no, he wasn't wrong.
Yeah, I don't think he was wrong either.
And she need her ass whooped.
Yeah.
Couldn't be my brother because I had a dog walking.
Too old for that. You're too old for that. Like...
But she was in her. What was it, like 20?
She's
too old
anywhere
for that.
From 28 to 32.
You're too old for that.
And he's 20 years older than her. So you telling me you mess around with this 50-year-old man and you don't know your coochie?
That's what I'm saying. You're too old for that.
Yeah.
I don't care how he said
it. Sit in that bathtub, okay?
Exactly. You got to submerge that thing every now and again.
Like, what? Or are you messing with too many people where it's changing? Like,
it's changing. It's throwing off your pH balance.
It's throwing it off.
But the thing could be maybe she haven't been exposed to how to take care of herself, though.
Who doesn't know
to take a bath?
I'm saying,
right,
like,
what?
So what if she was brought up by, like, street niggas who, a lot of street niggas don't take baths like that.
That's not an excuse. Like,
and then sometimes, so what if you wasn't taught? You don't know by 32 that you got
to
submerge every now and again?
Yeah. You can't just take showers and think that everything's going to get clean that way. You have to take a bath. Okay.
I laugh at people who say I don't take baths because I don't want to sit in that dirty water. I'm like, but the water shouldn't really
be dirty if you take it off.
If it is dirty, okay, whatever. Then you rinse off in the shower, however you gotta do it, but you got to submerge that cat every night.
You definitely have to take a bath.
From time to time. You gotta soak it.
I took one today because I need action today. You know I'm mad, but still. I'm still mad today, but I'm still, you know, we still women.
Yeah,
you already know what it is.
About to get this mad ass nut.
Right, but that's probably the best, right? That's one of the top three for sure.
Yes.
So, all right.
I always feel better with a bath anyway. Yeah. Like showers are okay, but during the week, weekend, I need to
submerge.
You feel like minty, like you just can't mentholize.
You feel
like
so much better.
And your muscles relax.
I feel better.
It's just, you know, glass of wine, a little bath.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's why I was running late this morning.
And too, she might also, she might be using stuff, products down there that she's not supposed to use.
Don't douche. Okay?
Yeah, it could be so many things going wrong down there. But at the end of the day, she smelled that cat before he did. So
had to.
When you go what you
or
have
for? You had to. If she did smell it before he did, and she used to it smelling like that, then she don't
that's
even know
disgusting.
No more.
That's disgusting.
Like, I mean, think about it. We've been around some people who have been smelling bad, but they don't even realize it because they always smell like this. Like, this is normal to them. Mm-mm. To us, we like, whoa, it's stinking here. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I get it, though. I get it. Hopefully she get it. Or hopefully she clean herself so she can get it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Or go back and mess with the young dudes that don't care how it's
that
now.
Don't care, right? That's what it is.
All right, Katie, let them know how they can find us, where we are, where we at.
You can find us on Instagram at Relationship Reality Podcast. Our personal pages, mine is Keisha.KD. His is Deontay_the_motivator. You can find us on Facebook at Relationship Reality the Podcast. You will have to request one of our personal pages to get on that page because it is a private page. You can listen to us on Spotify, Podbeam, Apple Music, iHeartRadio, and YouTube.
All right. And that is our show for today, man. The motivational quote for this week, man, is to do the best you can until you know better. Then when you know better, do better. It's your boy, man, DTM Deontay the Motivator.
And girl, Katie.
It's your girl, Kiki.
And we will see you next week. Peace.
Two of them.